Hey everybody, it's John with Freshwater Systems. Today I want to talk to you about reverse osmosis system maintenance. Reverse osmosis systems are great to have under your sink to provide you a high quality water to drink, to cook with, to run to the ice machine. A lot of uses for RO water. Well, to make sure that the quality of that water stays really high, these systems require periodic maintenance. And it really doesn't matter whose unit you have, whether it's a quick change or an older style with drop-in cartridges or some other configuration, even a countertop type system. It's very important that the pre-filters, the post-filters, and the membrane get switched out periodically. How do you know when? Well, let's get into that. All RO systems typically have a sediment carbon pre-filter, and the reason for that is to reduce chlorine so that it doesn't make contact with the membrane. If chlorine touches the membrane, it'll probably get destroyed, and you'll have to buy a new one pretty fast. So it's important to make sure that that pre-carbon filter is got plenty of capacity, and a good rule of thumb is to change it every year without fail. In some areas with high chlorine rates, depending upon the city supply, you may end up having to change it every 6 months instead of 12 months. And that's just, a lot of people like the safety of quick change or periodic changes, so they're staying ahead of destroying the membrane. The post filter is very important because it's polishing the water as it leaves the storage tank on the way to your faucet. And a good rule of thumb there is also annually. Now, the post filter doesn't see like the city water, raw city water coming in. It's seeing the good RO water coming out of the storage tank. So that one, you can change that annually and be pretty comfortable that it's doing the right job. The membrane, that's the heart of the system. It's the part that separates the contaminants from the water molecules, and that's the one that we protect with the filters, and that is the one that eventually you're going to have to replace. The kind of water you have will determine how frequently you need to change the membrane. If you gotta have a TDS meter, that's always a good way to check too. You can compare the rejection of the membrane, and as it starts to get worse and worse, you know the membrane is towards the end of its life. A membrane on hard water, you're probably going to have to change it every 2 to 3 years. A membrane on soft water, that could last 5 to 7 years as long as you keep replacing the pre and the post filters. Very, very important. But a very well-maintained system, and you're doing your cartridge replacements on a timely basis, the system will last a good long time. Now, the other things that you do or should do on a periodic basis just for maintaining the quality of water in the system is to actually drain the storage tank maybe before you go to bed so it has overnight to refill the tank. But a good maintenance step is to drain that storage tank down every couple of weeks. And what that does is it allows the system to completely turn the water in the tank. When you only use a little bit of water, the system is only refilling, say, the top portion of that tank. And that's really where the RO system is struggling to put water in that tank. So the rejection is not quite as good as it was when the tank was empty. So if you don't use a great deal of water, drain that tank down every couple of weeks so that you replace that water and the overall average quality of the tank doesn't kind of tail off because you're using it just a little bit. Another thing that you want to do, especially when you change the membrane, is to sanitize the tank. After a while, tanks, and I don't care whose system it is, tanks will grow some slime, and it's important to run some sanitizing solution and get rid of that into the tank, at least when you change the membrane, if not every other year. Good maintenance step. Well, that's the key things to do to keep these things working at their top performance level. And if you have any additional questions, let us know. We'll fill you in. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and find out all about RO systems at freshwatersystems.com.